Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be a Bath & Body Works semi-annual sale shopping guide, kind of like tips and tricks video. So, yes, I've never really filmed anything like this, so kind of exciting there. Yes, semi-annual sale is coming up for this summer, and I just thought I would throw together 5 tips and tricks that I use to score the best deals, shop the most efficiently, and just overall have the best experience at the semi-annual sale. So if you are interested in hearing about any of that, just stay watching. So a good starting point for this video, I guess, would be to discuss what the semi-annual sale is. So semi-annual sale, or SAS, commonly acronymed by us candle fanatics, is basically a sale that occurs twice a year at Bath & Body Works. Once is always in June. It's the first Monday in June normally. So that's the summer one. And the Christmas one occurs the day after Christmas, so December 26th. They are sales designed to kind of get rid of product. You know what I mean? Like, get them out of the way for coming seasons. So the summer one is obviously designed to get rid of everything spring and summer to make room in the stores for fall products. And the Christmas sale is designed to get rid of all the clearance Christmas items because they make the most Christmas products and need to get rid of them the most. So that is kind of in a nutshell what the semi-annual sale is. It runs for about a month. So this coming next Monday is June 4th. So that will start the semi-annual sale and it will end on July 5th. Yeah. July 5th. So they run for about a month, roughly. You know, some stores kind of carry a few products after the day that they technically end, but yes. So there was some background information on the semi-annual sale, and let's just go ahead and get into the, like, little tips that I wrote out. I have them on some old school paper here because I film with my phone and my laptop has an issue with the fan, so can't look at it during the video unless you all want to hear, like, some ungodly, like, grinding noises. So we got the paper, and I have 5 tips to share with you guys. I actually wrote these tips for, it was kind of like a random idea I thought of. I'm in a Facebook group called Babes of Bath & Body Works on Facebook, obviously Facebook group, I already said that, but I originally wrote these for that group, but I was like, why not make a video? That would be a great video, so here I am, and we'll just go ahead and start with the tips. So the first tip that I have is all about choosing a store. So if you're looking for, like, old, you know, kind of past seasons, like last fall, last Christmas, all that kind of stuff, you're going to want to look for the oldest stores you can, like the most run-down, like, hole-in-the-wall Bath & Body Works stores if you're looking for those kind of things, because the reason they have the most older products is because they, you know, just don't sell a ton of product, and when, like, seasons pass at Bath & Body Works and new stuff comes along, the stores have to box up old items, so they'll, like, basically throw everything into a box that didn't sell of the season that, you know, obviously can't be on the shelves anymore, and it will go into the back until semi-annual sales. So they will have the most of older items and, like, past season stuff. As far as, like, finding those stores, it's kind of, like, you have to, like, live in the area to know what stores are, like, low traffic, low volume. But yeah, so, I mean, not too many tips on there, like, finding the low-volume stores. It's kind of like you just have to, like, know the area. So, that kind of sucks. I mean, you can't just, like, call them and be like, are you a low-volume store? Because they will be like, what in the heck? But, yes. So, old stores for old product is pretty, I guess it would be a given. I don't know. And the next thing is, if you're looking for, like, newer things, kind of like test kind of items, you should definitely check out newly opened stores. What I find a lot is that if you go to a White Barn that has just, like, brand new, like, freshly been opened, they will oftentimes just, like, ship them, like, any product that they have at the warehouse to go, and they will just send it right to that store for sale. And personally, I experienced this last summer. A store near me opened, like, literally the day of the semi-annual sales start. So they actually got shipment of like a ton of like rare test stuff from last summer. So there was that like anal print collection they got, and that like iridescent glass collection. They had that in at sale price, which was, I can only assume they did it because they were kind of like having low stock issues and like needed stuff to fill the shelves. So there's a tip there. If you can find just like a freshly opened white barn near you, there you can find like test stuff from this past spring. And if you're looking for like a brand new like stuff that's coming to all stores, but you're kind of wanting it early, I advise going to like high traffic stores that are like in a very popular mall, you know, because they sell the most amount of stuff and they kind of get like bare shelves really fast because stuff sells out so fast, and that will result in them putting stuff out earlier than other stores, if that makes sense. So that was everything I had for the first tip. So take those tips, kind of feel out the area that you're going to be shopping during the semi-annual sale, and you can pick out some stores you want to visit. And that segues straight into tip number two, which is planning. So like I said, you know, take all of my advice from the first tip and kind of get a feel for the area around you and what their stores are like, you know, what stores are old and run down and no one goes to, and what stores are like super high traffic, like people are in and out of there like a million times every day, and, you know, kind of just see what you want and then organize what stores you want to go to first. And you can actually call them, or, you know, as you're shopping, you can ask what time they open on the semi-annual sale. Sometimes stores will open early in the morning for the semi-annual sale. My stores around me personally don't typically do that during the summer one, just because, I don't know. And so ask what time they open and you can kind of be there right on time, you know, see which ones open first and show up there accordingly. And also it really helps to like kind of make a list of what you're looking for at the certain stores based on, you know, their status and what they might have in stock. So also what I actually do, I know it's like totally like I have way too much time on my hands, why do I do this, but if you like plan according to the coupons, you can like be like, okay, if candles are 50% off, how many candles or does it take to get to that 40 mark? Obviously it's 4, but just like, you know, get that total there, and then you can like do the tax and everything with cash if you're super picky or want to like get your transactions down to like the penny. You can totally do that, you know, roughly like, okay, like how many about 75% off body care items can I throw into a 10 off 40 to get to that 40 mark before you take 10 off, and all the stuff like that. I don't know, does anyone care? Like, honestly, this is probably just only me because I have way too much time on my hands. Anyway, as far as like when you're actually in the store though, on June 4th or whenever you choose to go, what I personally do is I like to get those like mesh bags, you know, the ones that are on the little hooks in the store, and I like to just get a bunch of them and start like separating my transactions. And I'll actually get on my phone, I have this calculator app which allows you to like have like tabs within a calculator, and you can like add up like totals and then like multiply it by your tax and just get it all in there really good. So just like, you can catch me any day at the semi-annual sale with like a million bags hanging off my arms, just because that helps me in my mentally ill state sort out my transactions. And yeah, I think that's everything I have for tip number two. Moving on to tip number three, this is all about like picking the products to stock up on. So as far as that, it really changes weekly. Like all the deals just alternate like by the week. So if you go in your stores, you know, you'll be able to see, you know, sometimes online they'll be according to the sales in the store. And I don't know if this applies to everyone, but the stores near me get shipment on Mondays and Fridays. So it kind of like, it's another one of those things where like, do you really want to call and be like, what day do you get shipments in? But maybe if you like make friends with the sales associates, they can tell you what day that shipment comes in. So there is that. during the semi-annual sale, I always advise not to, like, try and wait on stuff. I know it can be really tempting to do this, but, for example, a collection might only be 50% off on the first day of the semi-annual sale, and you're kind of like, oh, I really want to wait for it to go 75% off because I'm with you, sister. They, just everything is a better deal at 75% off, obviously. But, you know, that leads some people to wait until it goes 75% off, and then they miss out, and it's, like, a whole bonanza, and, like, people, like, start crying. So, what I always advise is to go ahead and just buy it at 50% off, bite the bullet, just get, like, a few so you're not, like, heartbroken if it sells out. And what you can always do is keep your receipt, actually, and go back in the store if it goes to 75% off or lower or whatever, and you can do a price adjustment. So just tell the sales associate that you want to do a price adjustment, and they can, you know, I think they like return everything and then like rebuy it. I don't know. You don't have to bring the products back in, just bring the receipt, and they should be able to hook it up for you and get that like store credit back or whatever your original form of payment was. So always advise the price adjustments and not, like, trying to skip out too much on stuff that you really want. So, along with this stuff, like, the whole missing out theme, I have a list of all of the collections that are actually leaving for the semi-annual sale. So, the thing is, every semi-annual sale, they usually retire a few scents that, like, they're called Signature Collection. They stay on the walls year-round. So this year, it actually happens to be my number one favorite body care scent ever in this world. And that is Pink Cashmere. So that scent is leaving the stores for good. Typically, they start out at 75% off and stay that throughout the wholesale because, you know, they're trying to get rid of it. So that one is leaving, along with Amber and Argan, if you remember that one. Endless Weekend, French Lavender and Honey, Waikiki Beach Coconut, the whole mineral collection of body care, you know, that rose quartz and stuff. There's the Island Harvest collection, you know, the Island White Sand, Pink Lily and Bamboo, Fresh Mango and Sea Salt, I think that was all of it. And, you know, just basically all the spring collections. I think that there was the, like, Garden Distillery or something like that, with the Wild Rose and Apple. Basically, everything spring is leaving, you know, you can't expect it to stay. So that will probably be alternating 50 to 75% right there. And also, there is the men's collection. The suede scent is leaving, so if you like that one, I know. I think that's actually my favorite men's scent from Bath & Body Works, suede is. So that one is leaving, and all of the men's scrubs are leaving the store, so probably 75% off, and that active collection of skincare. So that was everything I know of that's leaving. I think I found it from an Instagram page, so there's that. And what else? Talk about price adjustments and returning scents. I wanted to mention that. So we got mailers in the mail, obviously, today. So on the top, it lists the returning scents for this year. So I have it right here. They are Cucumber Melon, Pearberry, Dark Kiss, Sensual Amber, Country Apple, Cherry Blossom, Paris Amour, and Malibu Heat. So there are the returning scents right there, if you're interested in those. Now, those normally come back at, like, promo pricing. So, like, $3.50, $3.75, $4, somewhere in there. You know, it's not, like, a percentage off. So, I mean, that's just how they normally do it. Ugh, watch them not do it this year. So, those are definitely ones to stock up on. You know, some of them are, like, you can really, like, always count on being around, like, Cucumber Melon and stuff like that. But since, like, Malibu Heat, you know, you don't always see those. So, if you really like any of those, definitely don't pass up on them. So, there's that. So that was everything I had for tip number 3. And tip number 4 is all about coupons. So there are two forms of coupons from Bath & Body Works, like, dedicated for the semi-annual sale that are currently in circulation right now. And there is the email coupon that you can kind of expect to come further on in the realm of things. So the first form, the most recent form, is the mailer coupons right here. So, I got these in the mail today, which is at May 29th. The little, like, thing on the front says, like, it's a note to the postmaster. It says, deliver in home May 30th through June 1st. So, if you don't have yours by June 2nd, you can start to worry. So, I got 4 of them, which is kind of unusual. Normally, I get, like, 2 or 3. So, if you aren't already signed up for the mailers, it's kind of, you're kind of out of luck there. I know there's a whole, like, debate with people having trouble getting mailer coupons, actually. So, I've always got mailer coupons. So thankful for it because I know they're really hard to get. So, I think if you want to go ahead and sign up for them, even though you probably or definitely won't get these in time, you can just call the customer support hotline and they will help you get signed up on the mailer registry. So this is what the mailer coupon looks like. I like wrote out my address right there, but it's just a 10 off 40 valid June 4th through July 5th right there. It can't be combined with anything, but if you spend $40, you can take 10 off. So there's a coupon right there. There's the returning cents. And here's what the back looks like. And also, there was a bounce back coupon handed out in stores for the past few weeks, which looks like this. It's the same thing, just the 10 off 40 coupon right there on the bottom. Valid through the same dates. So there was that. If you have any older coupons like 10 off 30s, 20% offs, I'm not sure if they're valid because I've used all of mine, but there's a 3-day grace period. So whatever date the coupon technically ends, you can use it 3 days after that. And if your store allows you, you can do multiple transactions. And if you have different stores in your area, go to all of them and use your different coupons because some get kind of grouchy. They're like one coupon per customer, which is, you know, it's like in the fine print on the back, but some are more lenient about it than others. And that was tip number 4. And the last tip, number 5, is just about finding the good products. So with this, especially in Bath & Body Works stores, they have like in the bottom of tables, like there's like a flat area on the bottom of a table where you can sometimes find good stuff under there. So there's a tip. And sometimes people will actually try and hide things that they like want to come back and buy later at the bottom of the bins. So look through those. Also, I always think that it's the best to go on the first day of the semi-annual sale just because the selection is the best. But like I said, does alternate weekly, you know, they might get things returned to them and stuff like that. You know, people argue about this a lot too, but I always have looked through the drawers during the semi-annual sale, you know, especially in like newer White Barn stores, they'll have drawers where you can open and kind of look through there. Maybe if the store isn't super busy or you're like cool with the sales associates, that's more acceptable there. And, if your store is super busy, like, very overwhelming, I always say go to the 75% off tables first. Grab what you want, because, you know, that's the tables that people flock to more. And also, if you see something, like, off the wall, super, super old, definitely have a sales associate, you know, take it and scan it, because sometimes in very odd situations I've seen, stuff will ring for 90% off, if not, well, actually, 75% or 90% or something like that, if you see something, like, crazy old. And, yeah, that's actually everything I have written down for as far as tips for the semi-annual sale. So, yeah, thank you all so much for watching, and I wish you all tons of luck finding all of the best things at the semi-annual sale. Bye!